Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel, where we dive into project management and agile methodologies. Today I'm excited to share with you how I created a customized JIRA issue type called Portfolio Epic, tailored specifically for lean portfolio management. In this tutorial, we are going to take inspiration from the Scaled Agile Framework, SAFe, and focus on the lean portfolio management aspect, particularly the portfolio epic. However, I have adapted it to be more pragmatic and applicable to real-world scenarios, especially when dealing with the operational side of lean portfolio management. First, let's talk about why we need a portfolio epic in the context of lean portfolio management. In SAFe, the portfolio epic is a large initiative that spans multiple agile release trains, ARTs, and development value streams, DVS. It's a crucial element for aligning strategy with execution and ensuring that significant business initiatives are properly managed and tracked. To implement this in JIRA, I'm using the Atlassian toolchain, with JIRA at the forefront. JIRA's flexibility allows us to create custom issue types that fit our unique needs. I created a new project in JIRA, Operational Portfolio Management, dedicated solely to managing portfolio epics. This project has one main issue type, the portfolio epic. Let me walk you through the fields I've set up for this issue type. First, summary, standard JIRA field. This is a headline for your portfolio epic. It should be a concise, descriptive title that gives a quick overview of what the epic is about, and it's also a standard JIRA field. Second, epic name. This is a more detailed name for the epic, which helps in distinguishing it from other epics in reports and roadmaps. Third, epic hypothesis statement. Here, we define the hypothesis or the underlying assumption driving the need for this epic. This field encourages a hypothesis-driven development approach, ensuring that each epic has a clear purpose and measurable outcomes. It is already filled out with the default text to help the user. 4. Description. This field is used to provide a detailed description of the epic, outlining the objectives, scope, and any important details that stakeholders need to be aware of. In context of agile methodology, following descriptions are required. Business outcomes, leading indicators, and non-functional requirements, NFRs. 5. Development value streams, DVS. DVS are linked to agile release trains, ARTs. In this field, we specify which value streams are involved, helping to visualize and manage how different parts of the organization contribute to the epic. 6. Epic owner. This field identifies the person responsible for the epic, usually a senior leader or product manager who oversees the epic's progress and ensures alignment with strategic goals. 7. Business owner. The business owner is a stakeholder who benefits from the epic. They are responsible for defining the business needs and ensuring that the epic delivers the expected value. 8. Architects. This field lists the architects involved in the epic, who are responsible for ensuring that the technical solution aligns with the enterprise architectural standards and principles. Let's take a look at an example of a portfolio epic we are going to create. Notice how each field is populated to give a comprehensive view of the epic. This setup ensures that all necessary information is captured and that the epic can be effectively managed and tracked throughout its life cycle. And there you have it, a step-by-step guide on how to create a portfolio epic in JIRA for lean portfolio management. By using this customized issue type, you can ensure that your large-scale initiatives are well organized, strategically aligned, and effectively managed. Be aware that it's only an example and does not fit everyone. If you found this tutorial helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more project management and agile tips. Don't forget to hit the bell icon to get notified whenever I upload a new video. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.